Hello everyone. Igor Ekimov, electrical engineer, is here. Today, I'm reviewing the interesting TCTE09L Wi-Fi thermostat from TEOK. This programmable thermostat can be controlled both offline and online as part of a smart home system. This thermostat has a pleasant design with a white frame. A black frame is also available. Choose the one that best suits your needs. This thermostat is used to regulate room temperature using underfloor heating and other heating equipment. I've included a link to the store where I ordered the thermostat in the description. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss new videos. Special thanks for your likes and shares. In the video, we'll cover installing, connecting, and configuring the thermostat, as well as controlling it through a mobile app, both with and without it. Connect the thermostat. The wires are secured with screw clamps. Connect the live wire to the first terminal and the neutral wire to the second. Particular attention should be paid to the correct connection of the neutral wire to the phase wire. Otherwise, the neutral wire will be interrupted and the heated floor will be constantly under the phase wire. Connect the heated floor or the water-based underfloor heating control to the third and fourth wires. The external temperature sensor is connected to the sixth and seventh wires. A sensor with a 3-meter cord is included in the kit, but another 10-comb sensor will work if one is connected to the installation location. Before starting, carefully check the correct wiring connections and the tightness of the connections. Incorrect connections can cause the thermostat to fail. This thermostat is easy to install. The display can be removed with a flat head screwdriver. There are holes here for securing the thermostat to the electrical box with screws. First, second. This thermostat is assembled in the reverse order. First, secure the top, and then snap the bottom into place. The thermostat is assembled. The thermostat takes up 3.5 centimeters of space in the wall box, while a standard wall box is 4 centimeters deep. Therefore, I recommend pre-wiring the supply wires inside the wall box to avoid interfering with installation or using a recessed wall box. The thermostat has a large black screen with 5 touch buttons underneath. The information on the screen is well thought out and looks quite impressive. Information is clearly visible when looking at the screen from above or directly from almost any angle. The screen is large, measuring 8.5 by 8.5 centimeters, so it is not suitable for installation in blocks with other sockets. Standard frames are 8 by 8 centimeters. The screen has a protective film that can be removed immediately after repairs. I will remove it now. This thermostat can switch an active load of up to 3.5 kilowatts and regulate the temperature from 5 to 45 degrees Celsius. It is possible to increase the upper control level to 95 degrees Celsius. The room temperature for installation of the thermostat should be between minus 5 and 50 degrees Celsius. Avoid installing the thermostat in damp areas and locations where it may be exposed to splashing water. All settings are stored in the device's non-volatile memory. In the event of a power outage, the thermostat returns to the mode it was in before the outage. If the internet is disconnected, it operates according to the previously set program. When connected, it syncs with the app. It's more convenient to control this thermostat online. Let's install the Smart Life app for this. Other apps that work with the Tuya Smart Home System are also suitable. Search for Smart Life in Google Play. Select the app, install it, and register. You'll see an Install button. I'll click Open because it's already installed. If you already have a smart home system, you might be able to connect this thermostat to it. Open the app. Setting up the thermostat in the app is quite simple. Turn on Bluetooth and Wi-Fi on your phone. Turn off the thermostat and hold the button. The Wi-Fi icon and the following animation will appear. In the app, click the plus button to add a device. The app has found our thermostat. Click it. Fill in the details of the Wi-Fi network the thermostat will be connected to. Wait for the thermostat to install. The thermostat is installed. Click Finished. Sometimes the thermostat doesn't connect automatically, so you can connect it manually. Click Plus, Add Device. Select Other, and then Other Wi-Fi. Set your home network parameters. Next, click Make sure the indicator is blinking. The app will then find the thermostat. I have it installed, so I'll skip this step. Now we've entered the thermostat settings, and I notice that the thermostat has retrieved the time, day of the week, and outdoor humidity from the internet. It also displays that it's currently clear. If it's raining, a rain cloud is displayed. The thermostat appears on the app's main screen. Click on it. This is what remote control for the thermostat looks like. At the top, we can change the name to something more convenient. Click it. Click the pencil. We can rename and set the location of the thermostat if we've already defined the rooms. Below, we can manually set the floor temperature. Here I set it to 32 degrees and our heated floors turned on. Now I reduced it. Our heated floors turned off. Just below it is the sensor temperature displayed, and whether the heated floors are on or off. Further down, we can switch to either manual or automatic mode. Next, we can enable the child lock. As you can see, a lock is displayed here. When we try to press the keys, nothing happens except a beep. Let's turn it off. Let's turn on additional settings. The antifreeze mode is essentially an antifreeze mode. The controller will turn on the floors if the sensor temperature drops below 5 degrees, even if the heating is not on. This prevents the room from freezing. I will leave this mode. Next is the weekly program. Setting up the automatic mode. We select the number of weekdays and weekends. 5 plus 2, 6 plus 1, or all weekdays. I leave it at 5 plus 2. Next, we set up the automatic program for weekdays. Everything is clear here. 6 periods, each labeled. Let's adjust the first period. Press the arrow. Here, we can adjust the start time and the temperature it will maintain. We also set up a program for the end of the week, that is, weekends. Exit. Next, we adjust the backlight in standby mode. I set it to 100% while recording the video. I usually set it to 50%. I like the display to be lit even in standby mode. You can turn off the display at night by enabling this feature. Here, we set the start and end times for the display to turn off. Exit. Next, we can adjust the temperature sensor readings if necessary. This adjusts the current sensor selected in the settings. The sensor itself can be selected in the thermostat settings. We'll talk about this later. Exit the advanced settings. Next, we can view statistics by day and month. Turn the thermostat off and on. Thanks to the smart home app, we can coordinate the underfloor heating with other smart home elements and create shared scenarios. You can also connect voice control via Alice or Marusia. But that's a topic for other videos. Don't forget to subscribe. Let's look at how to control the thermostat without an app. This button switches between the thermostat's operating modes. There's manual mode and automatic mode. Let's turn on manual mode. This is indicated by the hand icon on the display. In this mode, the thermostat maintains the set temperature for an extended period. The sensor temperature is displayed on the left, and the temperature being controlled by the thermostat is displayed on the right. If the sensor temperature is lower, the heating turns on. If it's higher, the heating turns off. We can adjust the maintained temperature using the up, down buttons. When the heating is turned on, the floor of the house shows the floor turned on. Now let's decrease the temperature. The maintained temperature becomes lower than the ambient temperature. The thermostat turns off the heating, and the underfloor heating icon disappears. The thermostat has a child safety lock. If you hold the up and down buttons for a while, the keypad lock is activated, and a lock icon lights up. Hold it down again for a while, the lock is deactivated and the icon disappears. You can turn the thermostat on and off using this button. A short press of this button activates energy saving mode. In this mode, the floor heating does not exceed 18 degrees Celsius. Press it again to deactivate this mode. Holding this button enters the clock settings mode. Here we set the hours in minutes. We can adjust the up and down buttons in set the day of the week. To enter programming mode, press this button and the clock lights up. The day is divided into intervals. Here, icons are displayed symbolizing which interval the thermostat is in. Each interval has its own settings. On the right, the temperature maintained during a given time interval is displayed. There are 6 intervals for a weekday and 2 for a weekend. Here's an example of setting up the thermostat in automatic mode. Here are the settings for a weekday. The first is waking up. The second is leaving for work. The third is arriving for lunch. The fourth is leaving for work after lunch. The fifth is arriving from work. The sixth is nighttime sleep. For weekends, there are only 2 modes, day and night. The interval start time and the maintained temperature should be adjusted to your needs. Long press the M key to enter the automatic mode setup mode. Set the minutes, then the hours, then the temperature for a given time interval. We configure all time intervals in this manner. The icon for the given interval is displayed here. Here are the days of the week for which this interval is set. We program weekdays and weekends sequentially. In our case, the thermostat exited this mode automatically. Or we can force it by pressing the network button. If we are in automatic mode but need a different temperature, we can adjust the current temperature using the up and down buttons. In this case, a hand and a clock are displayed simultaneously. The set temperature will remain in effect until the start of the next time interval in the thermostat program. Next, the thermostat will switch to automatic mode. To get more options from the thermostat, you need to go to the advanced settings mode. To do this, turn off the thermostat and turn it on while holding the M key. The first item is not used, and I do not recommend touching it. The next item allows you to adjust the temperature sensor readings, if necessary. Click and select a sensor. The built-in sensor is selected by default. We can change it to an external sensor or enable both sensors at once. We leave the built-in sensor. At the moment, my external sensor is not connected. For operation with underfloor heating, I recommend enabling the external sensor. The next item is overheat protection, adjustable from 5 to 60 degrees. We leave the default setting of 35 degrees. The next item is hysteresis. We leave it at 1 degree. Next is freeze protection. I enabled its app. Next, switch the number of working and weekend days. The default is 5 working days and 2 weekends. We can set 6 working days and 1 weekend, or all 7 working days. We leave it at 5 plus 2. Next is the startup delay. It's not recommended to touch it. It prevents the floor from turning on more frequently than the set interval. Next is the maximum temperature. It can be adjusted from 5 to 95 degrees Celsius if necessary. Next is a factory reset. To do this, hold the up button for more than 5 seconds. I won't reset it. Next, the settings cycle through. Turn it off. Turn the thermostat on and enter operating mode. Let's draw conclusions. It's worth noting the versatility and multifunctionality of this thermostat from TEOK. You can initially install it as a regular programmable thermostat. Later, connect it to a smartphone app and control it remotely. The next step is to integrate it into a smart home system. It has a beautiful design and will fit into almost any interior. However, it's important to keep in mind that you'll need a dedicated electrical box for this thermostat. This thermostat is useful when your schedule is weekly and rarely changes. When changing the schedule, you can either switch the thermostat to manual mode or reprogram it. You can also reprogram or control it remotely. I've included a link to this thermostat in the description. Share the video with friends who might be interested in this topic. Subscribe to the channel and click the bell to stay up to date with new videos. I'd appreciate your likes and reposts. Please share your questions and experiences with this thermostat in the comments. See you in new and old videos.